Welcome to this Headless Professor video on the proper use of the term random. Random is a statistical term frequently applied to social science research, and what it refers to is equal probability. It does not mean that something is done haphazard. Random is most usually applied to areas of sampling and assignment in experiments. Let's suppose that this is our population, a total of 6 different bottle tops. And suppose we wish to make a sample of these 6. How should we do it? Well, random selection is one option. And remember, random means equal probability. The purpose of good sampling is that the resulting sample should represent the parent population in terms of having similar levels of background variables. One way that sampling should not take place is by a mere sampling of convenience. In other words, the sample that was easiest to get. This is the way that most student projects are actually done. For example, here we have a sample of 6 bottle caps. It's easiest for me to grab these 2. But that sample of convenience was not representative because the 2 cases that were easiest for me to grab were not really representative of the population. If you get your sample of students coming out of the library, you may overly represent those students who had classrooms close to the library, such as the history students, and you may underrepresent those students whose classrooms were far away from the library, such as the nursing students. So, if you're looking for a good sample, do not assume that a representative sample comes from a sample of convenience. Another kind of problematic sample is the self-selected sample. For example, going back to our population of bottle tops, if we ask who's going to volunteer to be in our survey, me, 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 suppose these 2 volunteered. Well, they would not be representative of the population. Whenever you do a sample by telling people, come to my website, click on this link, and take my survey on SurveyMonkey, that is a self-selected sample. That is not a representative sample. One way to get a representative sample is by a random sample. In other words, this means that each particular case would have the same chance, the same probability of winding up into our final sample. And that would tend to make it more representative, especially if the sample was large. Another possibility is we could do a stratified sample. We could intentionally take the same proportion of subjects in our sample as exist in the population. Going back to our example here, we have a population of 6. Suppose we're only going to do a sample of 3. Well, the proportion is for more blue than black, so let's have this be our sample. It preserves the same proportion of blue to black. Another use of randomization occurs in experiments. In experiments, we have 2 groups, an experimental group that is treated one way and a control group that is treated a different way. Once again, randomization can be useful. What we need to do in our grouping is to preserve a balance between the 2 groups of background variables. once again, let's suppose this was our sample in our experiment. And we wanted to divide these cases into two different groups that we were going to treat differently. Well, if we put all the blue caps in one group and all the black caps in another group, and treated the blue caps one way and the black caps a different way, we would not know if the differences that resulted in the behavior of these two groups was due to the fact that one group started off being blue and the other black, or if one group was treated one way and the other group was treated a different way. We could use proportionate grouping so that each group gets the same background proportion as the other group, or once again, if the groups were large enough, we could use random assignment so that each individual case had an equal chance of winding up in the experimental group. Therefore, random selection and random assignment are good things. They prevent confounding variables from creating problems in social science research.